Jackson has forked over 95% of a $120,000 contract for a second-story addition and kitchen remodel on his Riverdale, Maryland home. But it's only 15% complete, and by May of 2004, work has come to a total stop.
You know, I'm looking outside, I see piles of red clay. I'm looking out into what should be a family room that doesn't have hardwood floors, or electrical work completed, or bathrooms that don't have toilets or sinks.
For more than 6 months, Jackson and his family are forced to live in a stalled construction site, while Craig Oliver continues to ply his client with lies.
He was still calling us and telling us that he's going to show up next week and he's going to install our kitchen. And we hadn't seen cabinets, we hadn't seen, appliances, we hadn't seen anything. We had a sinking feeling that all our worst fears were realized. We had paid for everything, and we haven't received even half of what we had paid for.
Jackson's neighbor, Carol DePrado, is also left with just a shell of her $83,000 garage rebuild.
I wrote the last check to him, and that was it. The garage was just wood framed with particle board. It wasn't covered. It was exposed to the weather, and it was November at that point, so it was starting to rain, and I'm calling and calling and calling, and I'm not getting anywhere with anybody.
If experience is a guide, Craig Oliver knows that most of his clients have little recourse. But the con man makes a fatal mistake when he picks the wrong person to victimize. One of the homeowners he has been lying to also happens to be an FBI agent.